after several hours of walk, finally we made up to the St. George Castle. This is the highest point of the city.
And this castle is very big. It was built 900 years ago by the Moors or Arab people. And whoever was the king at that time, I forget his name, actually St. George. George, and king name was George. He took over the Arabs. He married an English lady from an aristocrat chalat, and they renamed this castle St. George Castle. Once again, this is 900 years old, and the pass, it used to be very important responsibilities or things to do. This was protecting the harbor. You can see it on the river where the boat came in from the ocean. It used to be a harbor. Actually, even today, if you go there, we see the old things when they tied up the boats at that time. The castle has a very rich history. They even used in the Second World War protecting this harbor. Then they restored it, rebuilt it, and today there's tourists visiting it. But a lot of tourists. Let me tell you, we have to stay in the line for a long time, and we even were cheating a little bit, skipped here and there, make it shorter. Getting not cheap, just the entry, 15 euro, little to tour guide. The tour guide can go back up to 45. So we will see what this castle will show us. However, a view on the city is beautiful. On the background, that bridge, it looks like a bridge was built in San Francisco. And the interesting thing is exactly the same firm designed and built, constructed the bridge by the same company who built the San Francisco Bridge. On the other side of the river is not Lisbon anymore. This is Lisbon. I'm not sure what is there, but a quarter away you can see other city. On the back, a new part of the city. That white building is our hotel. We have many white buildings. The narrow white tall building is our hotel.
Here is a cannon, year 1622, which is 500 years old, and still in one piece. Probably not built by China. I don't think it would last for 500 years long. Still impressive, the size of it. We joined our tour on Saturday evening. They take around in the places, including a dinner. So we made some investigation where tourists talk. We found it. However, an interesting part next to this tour starting place is a marketplace, a book marketplace. I never in my life saw
so much book in one place like here. It's just out of this world. How many books and books are here? I love books. Like probably few of you know, I grew up in the bookstore. My mom all her life worked in the bookstore. My sister owned the bookstore. And end up here in the middle of, I don't even know where I am exactly. I just know 30 metros stop. In the middle of the marketplace, not selling anything as a book. And of course, drinks and food, like everywhere else. Book, drink and food. But more likely just book. I don't even see drinks here. Just books. Do you see any food or drink here? Yeah. What is a BJ?
There.
You want something to drink?
I want to ask the trip.
What trip?
Next trip, if we get.
Oh, you want to go back to the woman on the next trip? What is the next trip?
That is a ice cream.
Popcorn. Popcorn station. Here we go, a restaurant. Ice cream. Hola. So. And there is another end on the other row. Steel book. And I can't see on the end here. A book. How long is it? Yes. Like a kilometer long?
Yeah.
Look at this.
Yeah, this is what kind of book?
What kind of
book you're looking for here?
Yeah. No, I don't want to carry. Oh, yeah, in the dark, eh? I can sleep on the airplane too. One of the selling e-books here too? I don't think so. It's kind of complicated. Who would think this one, so many books were selling here? In Hungary, all the small bookstores been taken over by big chains. Everything is close to the airport, a close a relative walk, not a walking distance. The plane is coming home, so it's not that far. Books and books and books. Going the other line, what about works? Get some more book. More books for you. Yes, other restaurant. Wanna drink something? No? Okay, then go back and we turn around. Here is some concert happening too, the festival weekend. Okay, say goodbye for the books now. So I was sure I finished with the book market. My wife changed her mind and she wanted to look around a little bit more. So we came to the other side, which is even bigger than the first side. Here is three line of stores. Over there is two line of stores. So altogether is five lines, or lanes, whatever. According to Google, they're close to 1 kilometer long. So that is a 5 kilometer bookstores here. You can see we are up on the hill and up front was the river and the old town, which is not changing the fact I never in my life saw this much book, this many book in one place and people buying book. It's incredible. And other interesting thing, like many small show is going on, like a writer meet with the readers, talk about the book, signature of the book. We start three, or we see three different persons, three different writers. One live show on the TV. So they marketing the books big time. I'm nothing like Hungary. I'm sorry to say, I am Hungarian with all my heart. But and my mom used to work in the bookstore. She had only one job all her life, which was a bookstore. But I cannot even imagine before anything like this. It's just incredible. I cannot find a word for it. Also, some children shows went up, so they already try to make kids to love the books. Like one place, I could not tape it because like YouTube has a policy for don't show children. They play the drum, about 10 kids, all of them just drum. It was very impressive actually, and I don't think all 10 of them together was 60 years old, so around 5 to 7 years old, around that. They were pretty good. I'm not sure how is a book related for the drum, but one thing is for sure, a kid's here, spending time here, is getting friendly with the books. Or the other place has a Muppet show with the kids, so it's a smart way to make the kids love book. And finally, I say goodbye from the book.
That man at the top, his name is marquisopombal.
This place, this plaza, around about, is carry his name. As the, all the national hero, they put them up high. He was a very powerful man, and the lions next to him represent the power. Unfortunately, a catastrophe made him powerful. 1755 was a big big Portuguese earthquake. Like, it's questionable how many people died, but the latest writing states 60,000 people died. It's happened in September 1st. September 1st, they have All Saint holidays, celebrate the All Saint. Many people was in the church, candle lighting, lots of decoration, and the earthquake is came so powerful. It's created 2-3 meter wide cracks on the ground, so church collapsed, people died in. Then, because there was lots of candle, the fire came, so people run into the ocean, on the river, but the cracks made the river what they disappeared, and where the ocean met with the river, all kinds of boats with treasures on the bottom of the river, so they run there, collect those treasures, and the tsunami came. So 60,000 people died. And this man was the prime minister at that time. Actually, they say the prime minister, but at that time wasn't the prime minister, because Portugal was an empire. So he was the first man in the empire. Maybe right word to say interior minister. So he rise to power, and he said, bury the dead, and heal the alive. So on the bottom of the statue, you can see the horse and the people working, and there is a boat, which represents who died in the tsunami. The people who work, they represent how they lived. Oh, the bus just came in front of me. Sweet. What can I do? Move a little bit. So the people who works over there, they represent the rebuild Lisbon. And there is a naked woman. And many of the monument has a naked woman. And the naked woman represents fertility. So we survive. Offspring, newborn. A nation will go on. At that time, many Portuguese people question their religion, because why? We go to the church to celebrate, and we die. unfortunately, it was a wrong moment. However, since 1755, have a quiet few earthquake here.
That one was very strong. According for the today's technology,
that one was the strongest earthquake ever hit Europe. It was around 9 on the Richter scale. And that man upstairs, up there, he was the one who started to work on the Richter scale to measure how strong is the earthquake. But Richter scale didn't get a name from him. It's called the American scientist. However, he was the one who started the idea to let's measure these things, let's face it, try to get prepared for it. So that's why he's up there today.